So the calcinated carbonate compound form of diamond is known as Hiraka Bhasma. And the second thing is Vajra Abhraga Rasayana. Vajra is no doubt diamond and Abhraga is mica. How many people can prepare that? Number one. Number two, even if they prepare, where is the evaluation or precision evaluation machinery to ascertain its genuinity, purity and efficacy? Number third, even if it is there, where is the sturdity level of a patient? Homeopathy, the medicines, it will work very nice if you are not taking tobacco, alcohol, coffee or tea. The rate of function will be more because of the body nature. Likewise, if a person is very much pure, ritualistic, then a lot of other qualities are there, spiritual qualities and intellectual qualities and mental sturdity is there. If the person is an empowerment or embodiment of all of these qualities, then certainly there are two possibilities. He won't get that risk at all, the type of disease at all. Number two, even if it is a karmic bondage to get the disease, he can have a good drug response. What is the benefit of spiritual life? Spiritual life gives you five benefits. It won't give you that type of cruel disease at all. Number two, even if it is given, it will be totally extirpated. It won't be sustainable. Number three, even if it is not sustainable, you are a good responsive person, spirit for a drug. Number four, even if it is there, you will be having the courage to face it. Number fifth, that is a greatness. Even if you are having that disease, it won't affect your spiritual progress and your routinal work at all. These five things are the blessings of spirituality. This is very much interesting and very much awe-inspiring, which everybody must practice. Spiritual things, they don't demarcate or filter you from diseases. Apart from removal of diseases, response to drugs and mental sturdity and balance and routinal way of continuing your prosperous and blissful life without minding the disease at all. If this is here, then what is the problem for me? I can just follow my pathway. Just as considering it as a different sheath, Annamaya Kosha, and our existence as a Vijnanamaya and Anandamaya, we don't mind that thing at all. It is just like a brick kept in a neighbor's house. Or if the brick is kept inside this chair or inside your desk. So if something is kept at the top or inside or front and bottom of an insentient creature which is not connected with us, which we never mind, that don't affect, that does not having any proper way of creating an impact in our mental balance. Likewise, we consider this body as well as the malady and remedy to be unconcerned, totally far beyond our concern and necessity, so we won't get at all. These things are the pentafold blessings and benefits of spiritual courage, not spiritual belief. We are all believers. Believers won't get the benefits. Belief is a threshold for getting the courage. Belief is the threshold for getting power. Mere belief is not power. Most of the people are unorganized and spiritualism has not grown because most of the people, they must start with believers. Now they are carrying their own beliefs without progressing in the other successful pathways. They started with belief, running with belief, and they will end with just belief, not anything at all. That is the problem with the spiritual domain, where some renaissance, there are some lightning, there are some great person for the resurrection of the spiritual community must come as Ramanujacharya or somebody else is there, and they must reinstall the spiritual glory and sensibility and commitment of each and every person. That is entirely different. So this targeted therapy, all of these therapies are now in new innovation. Our own special therapies, like I have told in Ayurveda, then yoga consists of good therapies. Then Prakritika Chikitsa is naturopathy. It has lot of therapies. So a person, just by consuming, I may give some tips as we are planning to start one spa, Sanjeevani. Papaya, see, anything that is having a bitter taste is against cancer. You take juice of papaya, not papaya fruit. This is unripened papaya and nobody can drink, I think so. Just consuming it, spoon by spoon, at least 50 ml a day, it works very miraculously with these people. Then hydrotherapy. Then consuming just fruits, nothing else. That reduces 20% of advanced cancer and 65% of cancer in the beginning stage. Let us take a holistic way. And homeopathy, no doubt, it is having a good systemic study. It has not originated in our land. So we just leave it. This Prakriti Chikitsa is there. It is very efficacious. Yoga is also there. What is the capability of yoga, Prakriti Chikitsa and Ayurveda? What is the difference? Ayurveda as well as the naturopathy treatment, you have to advocate. But yoga is bivalent. You can do it for yourself as well as radiate others. Dhyana, asana, you can do for yours. Yama and Niyama you cannot do for others. Asana you cannot do for others. Pranayama and Pratyahara you cannot do for others. But Dhyana and Dharana are the two experiences in the Eightfold Yogic Path meant for others. Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Samadhi, all of these six steps are meant for self-experience and bliss. You cannot say that Samadhi is for him. That gives a different meaning. So, this Dhyana and Dharana is communicable. The power of your contemplation, the power of your sincere, that is obeisances and obedience in spiritual practice and belief, that becomes a prowess which is transmitted, radiated even to non-believers. So by yoga, we can install such an institute where the practitioners can treat others. Where the treatment is for the patients, we can have naturopathy and Ayurveda. So yoga, Ayurveda, naturopathy, if somebody starts an institute, with the guidance of an oncologist, a proper oncologist, because they must certify to the world that it works. There are a lot of people successfully having done in Kottakkal Ayurveda Pharmacy, in Kairali Ayurveda Pharmacy, even they have treated a lot of previous and present presidents of India. There are a lot of records with even Yogesh Bendale, and there are a lot of living legends of the records of success, like Gadgilji, there are innumerable people like that. But still, for making it as a universal announcement and declaration with proof having eternal application and relevance with universal acceptability and authorization, it needs a different platform. So we must establish in our spa or any other area a holistic system of adoption. Then only we can get the utmost benefit. These are all the treatments. Then there is prognosis. What is prognosis in cancer? Prognosis is the art of predicting the lifestyle and lifespan of a patient after the treatment. How far he can run his life and how long he can carry it. How much he must be vigilant and meticulous. So all of these measures of life, all of these measurements of his life units, everything is studied in the science of prognosis. By seeing a patient, we must access and assess the person's durability, endurance and longevity as a post-treatment benefit by any of these methodologies. That is known as prognosis. Then six immediate connectivities for this cancer has been given by a lot of these people. One is the carcinogens, I have already told, like tobacco-like substances. Second is infection. Infection also creates problem. Third thing is radiation. Whenever the persons are working in radios, somebody told when we are giving lectures about meteorology, somebody asked, did our ancestors know that radioactive elements exist? That was the question. Then I told three reasons, some of which, one is, they knew about the radioactive elements as the radioactivity of those elements, the chemical elements, the geostatic or geodynamic radiological output that totally interferes and hinders with that of our biological radioactivity. So the bio, do you know that now cell phones, nobody is advocating to use cell phones in proximity. All of the electronic systems, we must be very careful. Nuclear reactors, we must be careful. Thermal power stations, we must be careful because of not only their nature of giving fatal results or outputs, because of the incongruity between the bioelectronic as well as the geoelectronic or the phenomenal electronic fields, they don't accept at all. Our radiation is mild and effective. We have thus much of systems inside our body, millions of nerves with millions of uncountable dimensions of functions they are advocating inside our body, and to create such a body with such type of functions and sustenance, the whole electrical production of the world and its voltage can sustain this body only for 3 seconds. According to the assessment, if we can create a body with all the responsive, reflexive, active, reactive, interactive principles of our body, if you are making it as an artificial thing, like what we call in science a cyborg, or a cyborobo, or an andro-robo, whatever it may be, if you create an organism with all of the functions and you want to supplement, instead of our consciousness, if you want to supplement it by electricity, the whole productivity of electricity in the world can make it run only for 3 seconds. So that much of the most mildest but very hyper-vigorous energy is within us, and it will contradict with these geospatial energy outputs which are very much vigorous in nature but thus lesser functions and fatal functions. So we must be very careful with these things. The radiations that have been coming from, there is biological radiations, there is radioactive materials and radiations, there are radiations of various spheres through communication signals, they even affect the body.